From days of long ago, from uncharted regions of the universe, comes a legend.
YouTube, it's Animated Plastic coming at you with another video review. This time I'm going to review the Hasbro Toys R Us exclusive masterpiece Thundercracker Transformer. Now, I did try to find this guy online. I was unsuccessful in purchasing him online on Toys R Us website. One of the things that kind of annoyed me about finding him was the fact that I actually had to break down and do what I've never done, which is I waited in front of a Toys R Us before it opened just to get this guy. So I kind of hounded the Toys R Us guy and told me they were coming in on the truck, so I waited in line and actually was able to purchase him at the store. I've never done that before for any figure, and I guess I don't know if I'm going to do that again, but I may do that with the Optimus Prime coming out, but I'm actually really happy to get it. I actually thought that the Hasbro, before I saw pictures, I thought Hasbro would just repaint and release the older Seeker mold for this guy, in the fact that you already had Starscream and Skywarp in the older mold. I don't know if some people were upset about that, being this one being the newer mold. I think it's nice. I'm not sure when it comes to the way they look together that this guy has a totally different style to him. I like the new mold. My only beef is that they didn't add wrist communicators to this one either. So I'm going to take a little bit different approach to this one. I'm going to actually do them side by side with the 25th anniversary Skywarp, so get a better look at what they what kind of some of the differences are, at least in this point from the packaging. It's got the Walmart sticker here. This one's got the Toys R Us exclusive, different color packaging as far as red versus the gray. Backgrounds are different. I like this better. I like the fact that it's a nice foil and it's not a sticker. I think it's printed right on the plastic. This is actually a sticker. This is nice. It's got the 25th year, but let's see, from the side, you'll see it's got his tech specs over here, but this one has the Masterpiece Skywarp here. It gives you some of the, I guess, the features of it. It says two different heads, but on all the reviews I've seen, I haven't seen anyone show that there are two different heads. It's got this really nice artwork on the side here, so let's take a look at the back, and let's see here. It shows a picture of the toy here, alt mode, it's got the cool tech specs, it's got a storyline. This one, more, I don't know, this one seems more rushed to me when it comes to production. I am a graphic designer by nature, so this kind of irritates me, the fact that there's so much open space down there. And I gotta say is they used the Generations Universe artwork. They didn't use any of the, I don't know, I guess I would expect them to take this artwork, maybe flip it, and recolor it in the Thundercracker pictures. But honestly, on the back, I'm surprised that they didn't just do this. They didn't take pictures of the toy and put it in the back. Kind of surprised in that. I will say this is kind of annoying when it comes to packaging. On the side, this looks really nice here on this side. You can tell that this one, they spent a lot more time on actually designing the package. I feel this one seems kind of rushed. That could be because, from my understanding, they pushed up the Thundercracker release and pushed back the Optimus release. But, you know, I don't know for sure. And this is kind of still what I think is really neat is the fact that it's got this thing about the 25th anniversary. It actually shows you the highlights rather than on this one where it kind of just does it with bullet points. So, I don't know. Regardless, I'm not going to look at the packaging all day, but I do say that when it comes to the packaging, one of the only things I really like is the fact that it's got this, and I do like this exclusive sticker from Toys R Us, but other than that, I really think that the Skywarp packaging is actually a better design. And without further ado, I'm going to go ahead and take this guy out of the package. Okay, here he is out of the package. I will say that I really like the figure. I did go over some of the stuff because I did read about Someone saying that some of the paint apps were kind of weird, and I did find what I think that they were talking about. I'll kind of go over that a little bit as well. First, got the instructions. Interesting enough to me, the instructions don't have like an actual picture of the figure. I guess it's line art. I guess it's kind of the same. This is the way the Masterpiece Skywarp was. So, one other thing that I found very interesting when I was opening it up, I did point it out on the box, is they showed this section here for switching the robot's face, but unless someone else can show me, I cannot find how to do that. So I don't think that that was in there. I think that was a mistake. I actually think that they were going to release Thundercracker in the old mold, and they changed their mind, and they didn't have a chance to update the instructions. I don't know. One of the cool things is it comes with a chromed pilot, and let's see here. I got the Dr. Ockerville. I mean, you can tell it's not the same character, and it's nice that they actually painted it this time, they chromed it, but it's a jet fighter. He's got a jet, you know, like a jet helmet on with a little line on it and stuff, so it's definitely not Dr. Ockerville. Let's see here, put that aside. I did already clip it on, but it comes with the clip for the Megatron Masterpiece version of the Megatron gun. It does, and it actually comes in a blue. All the other ones, I believe, were all Skywarp was black. This one was blue. When I got this Starscream, I didn't actually get one of those clips that came with it. I guess the guy had lost it, so I actually don't know what color that one was. I'm gonna guess it was gray, but I have no idea. It could have been black as well. So, well, without further ado, let me put them side by side so we can get a good side-by-side comparison. You will notice one of the cool things is that they did fix the legs. It doesn't have the hip kibble like this. They did attach it to the bottom. But they did also change the way the feet are. See, if you notice this one, the feet can actually swivel to the side. This one can't do that. It's more fixed, but that's one thing. And then now the null rays actually come out. They're on these ball joints. So you don't actually have to take them off like you do with these whenever you want to go from robot mode to alt mode. And you'll notice that on the head, let's see if I can do a little bit better here. You'll notice on the head that it's a totally different new head sculpt. One thing I notice is there's these springs. I don't know if that's just for ease of transformation to make sure it slips through that bridge back there or not. This one, I obviously can tell it comes with the second head, but this one, no, I actually took the head off and I tried. I actually thought the spring would actually release the face plate to let it come down, but it doesn't do that. So that's one thing that is totally different about the two. And I did notice that, I'm going to go ahead and spin around here, take a look up at the back. I mean, there are a lot of similarities when it comes to the figures, but there are some key differences. He's got these things on him. You can notice the Skywarp does not. They got rid of these, which I'm so happy about because I hated these little things. They always came off. But he does come with the missiles. The wings fold down. I mean, they do have very similar pieces of it. So the mold was very, I don't know how to describe it. They took the best pieces of it and they, improved on it. I don't know why they really did this with the null rays. I think that they could have done something a little bit better than making the null rays, but I guess it keeps them from having to come off, and I guess it keeps the plastic from wearing off. And let's see here. You got the missile pods, just like on the old one, and they did paint them, so that's a nice touch. The hands are the same to me. They look the same. They have the three fingers, just had the articulation, thumb. Let's see here. Really nice paint apps. I think they're decent. I think some really cool things about it is they have this thing called, it's a sonic boom. And I guess it's something that plays on what Thundercracker used to do with a sonic boom. And it actually, if you get one, you can tell it's Thundercracker holding what appears to be a Masterpiece sound wave, like kind of like a boombox. Can't really get a good shot of it here, so I won't really try much. Up in the S, the wings do kind of come off like the other ones. Oh, and speaking of, one thing, this is what people were talking about, is you can see this line of the here, let's see it here. But there's a kind of a paint app where they, you can see like a line. It's like they didn't finish, or they didn't finish applying all of it. So the paint app's a little sloppy on the tail fins. But other than that, I mean, that's really the only thing I see as far as the paint apps. Nice, you know, nice straight blue, red lines here. The Decepticon symbol's nice. Straight lines. I mean, I think it looks nice. I mean, I don't think that there's anything wrong with this. I just kind of actually find it odd that they didn't release Thundercracker in the older mold just to complete the set of the same style seekers. I don't know. I hope that they release the other two, Starscream and Skywarp, again in this. I mean, they already released the Skywarp or Starscream. I wonder if they're going to release the Skywarp. Well, they probably will in Japan, but not here in the U.S. But again, he does come with a really nice stand. He's got the words Thundercracker in the foil, which matches the Skywarp one, which is nice. It comes with the purple Decepticon symbol. So they all that part matches, which is really nice. But the molds are considerably different as far as what they look like whenever they're in robot mode. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and do the transformation. I will put a link in so you can skip this, but you get a chance to see how to transform the new mold from the robot to plane. Here we go. Go ahead and take this guy off the stand. And I'm actually going to take missiles off the back. And the feet are a lot different as far as how you transform them. You actually spin this around, this up. And then these actually come up. Now, where it used to just show the thrust vector, thrust vectors, now they actually collapse into the leg. Which is kind of nice, which is kind of cool. Let's see here. And lift him up, pull this up. So it really it does transform very similar to the original Seeker mold. They just fix some of the things that I think people really kind of got irritated with. The head is still kind of hard to get to go back into that piece. There we go. So. This piece up. This is the least favorite part of the masterpiece, of the center piece here. Fit these together. Collapse the hands. And I guess you got to make sure that you don't hit the panels there with that. So there's some differences here with it. Just take these off and spin them up. So, I mean, if you know how to transform the original masterpiece, then you pretty much won't have much of a problem transforming this one. I will say it's actually, so far, it feels easier to transform than the original, which is kind of a nice, you know, nice thing to have to worry about it so much. Oop.
Yes, I don't pull these up so fast. So they, what they did was they attached all of that piece right there onto the wing. So now there's pointed, little pointing things on the wing itself. And as you saw, it looks like this piece comes off. So to relieve pressure, if you pull too hard on it, like I did, came right off. But you saw it snaps right back in place. So it's not, and there's a tab there as well. It fits in. And there's a tab there. It slides up under. There you go. Piece. For a second, I was like, what? How's there this big gap in his legs? Flip the fin out. Air fins out. Fold this down. And then you can put the guns right there from the wings. And there you go. There he is in alt mode. And I'm going to go ahead and go over the differences as well in alt mode as well. So, all right, here he is in alt mode, fully transformed. He was very simple to transform as the masterpiece. I actually think he's a little bit easier to put together than the original mold, and the fact that they took off some of the little kibble and some of the pieces that made it a little bit more cumbersome. Kind of go over some of the standard features that came with him. He's got the opening cockpit. I put the pilot in there. He does have the nose cone that comes out, opens up. Also has the air brake. And I will say that a decent little detail, they actually did paint it gray underneath. There's actually some paint apps in there. Like I just said before, they did paint the tail fin with this thing called Sonic Boom, and it looks like they show a Thundercracker holding Soundwave. I don't know if that's like a hint that they're going to bring Masterpiece Soundwave out here or not, but I will say that that's sometimes what they do show other figures on figures showing that what else is coming out, and who knows, maybe they're going to do a reflector as well, since they did paint this on here too as well. If you can see it, it's a picture of the reflector, and it says Say Cheese on it, which is kind of neat. My camera doesn't focus very well on close-ups. One of the other things too is it does still have the thrust vectors, but it does, let's take this off, it does have two screws now, since they actually use them for the feet. It would have been nice if they would have painted them to match so they didn't stand out so much. I will say that the stand is a little bit different, as it has a groove now on the bottom here. There's a groove right there that the piece of plastic fits in, but other than that, it actually does the same thing where it fits in the plastic. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this guy back on there. So, and then yeah, so I'll just compare them. They basically are the same. The only big differences are right here. They took off all this kibble. So as you can see, that now it's not as panel formed here, so there's more opening on the side. And in the thrust vectors, you'll see here that they don't have the screws there since they're not used for the feet. And there is no like thing on the wings here or the intakes. But other than that, I mean, they both have the wheels. Let's see here. The only you know, obviously, they got the missile pods. They did a good job with this, with the white on the blue with some silver. So they did some good paint apps with this. So, I mean, overall, I'm really happy with the figure. I will say, though, that I am still surprised that Hasbro released this figure in the new mold rather than the old. I actually think it would have been nice to release the old one, just the fact that everyone that had the Walmart Starscream and Skywarp would have had a full set of the same Seeker mold. I do like the fact that this new one does not have the hip kibble. It is actually a very nice touch, but you know, it's kind of weird to have two figures the same in your set, and then you have one that's got a completely different kind of remold. But you know, that's pretty much, I think you can probably find someone to repaint an older mold into the Thundercracker. I will say it's a really nice touch with all the paint apps they did for the Sonic Boom, Say Cheese. I think those are neat. Some people don't really like them. Oh, one last thing is on that thing. It says Captain J Dragon Sass. I'm not sure who that is. I don't know if that's a call out to someone that maybe works at Hasbro or Takara or something like that. So, well, that's pretty much it. That's the review of Masterpiece Thundercracker. Thanks for checking it out, guys. Subscribe and be notified of new videos I'll upload. I will be reviewing a bunch of Creon stuff here soon, as well as finally getting around to the TFC Hercules Devastator set. I have some pretty big things planned for that as well. And I will be actually starting, I think, shooting or start doing some more stop motion on my show called Anime Plastic. All right, guys, take care. Thanks for checking it out. Bye.